I recently bought the Microsoft Office Home and Business 2021 suite of software applications. The main reason is that I want to upgrade my Office 2010 software to the Outlook 2021 version. I have been having problems with the Outlook email database. The file is called Outlook.pst. Email that I've saved have gone missing. The email database is about 3 gigabytes. I suspect that over time the email database has got corrupted. So before I use that Outlook.pst mail database on the Outlook 2021 software, I'm gonna clean that database. I'm going to run Microsoft's own Outlook inbox repair tool called SCANPST.exe to diagnose and repair errors in the Outlook data file. I hope we can find and repair all the faults, but it may not. I'm going to give you a demonstration running the SCANPST. This is the Microsoft website which explains what the SCANPST tool is. It says that you use the tool under situations where Outlook cannot open the data file, or Outlook cannot open folders, or you think that the data file may be damaged. And note that the SCANPST inbox repair tool does not connect or analyze data stored in the Exchange mailbox. The tool looks for errors, corruption, and if there are any, gives you opportunity to allow the tool to fix those errors. The website tells you where you can find the scanpst.exe file. I have Outlook 2021. I know that the file is stored in the 64-bit version of this location. On the Microsoft website, it says open the SCANPST file. You'll be asked to browse to the folder and the file location that you want to diagnose, and you'll be given the choice of whether you want to make a backup of the file before it makes repairs. On my Windows 10 64-bit PC, I found the location of the scanpst.exe file. It is on C drive, program files folder, Microsoft Office subfolder, root subfolder, Office 16 subfolder. The location will change depending on whether you have a 64 or 32-bit machine and what version of Office or Outlook you have. I will now click on scanpst to run it. That brings up a dialog box called Microsoft Outlook Inbox Repair. It asks me to browse to pick up the location of the mail database to be repaired. In this case, I have it here in my public temporary folder. Test Outlook 2010 mail database for demo.pst. It's 1 gigabyte in size. Click open and it puts the folder and file name in here. If I click on options below, I can choose whether to replace an existing log file or append to the log file or not have a log file. I prefer to just replace the log file. Click OK. There's the note that reads, before starting, you must quit Outlook and all mail enabled applications to diagnose and repair errors in the file. I do not have any Outlook applications open, so I'll click Start. It says initializing phase 0 of 8. It is checking file consistency, 8%, 9%, 10%, phase 1 of 8, reasonably fast. Obviously, the bigger your mail database, the longer it will take. Nearly finishing phase 1. Done, it's gone to phase 4 of 8, very fast. Phase 7 of 8, it's completed. It says errors were found in this file. To repair these errors, click Repair. Folders found in this file, 362. Items found in this file, 5,464. I can choose to make a backup of the scan file before repairing or not. I will choose to make a backup. It gives it a default name, the original name, and the end suffix .bak. If I click Browse, it gives me a chance to rename the file completely in the location I want. If I click on Details, it says internal errors were found in this file. They must be repaired for this file to work correctly. I'm now ready to click Repair. This will take a while. It's still working to repair the file. Right, the dialog box popped up. Repair complete. Click OK. I'll go to the folder which contains the mail database. As you can see, this is the file that has been repaired. This is the log file of the repairs. Let's open it up and have a look. So this is a log file of the repairs attempted. Now it's not clear to me when it says it has CS3 of 0 but should have 48, whether this is before or even after a repair attempt. Not very good clear messaging. Here it's attempted to validate BT ref counts. Couldn't find the entries. Failed to add row. And that's the last bit attempting to copy back NBT. From my reading of this log file, it appears to me that there are errors it is not able to fix. Alright, we'll close this. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video and found it useful. There are so many users of Microsoft Outlook applications out there in the world. I'm sure that many people who have this sort of problem with their Outlook.psd database file. So remember this, next time you have a problem with the Outlook database mailbox not opening or it seems the files may be corrupted, run this SCANPST.exe file to diagnose and repair the errors and hope that it fixes all of it rather than only some of it. Do subscribe to my channel for more and also to help the channel grow. Thank you so much.